روزه به عزت رسول اکرم صلی الله علیه و سلم را به ساعت مقدس آقای امام زمان جل الله تعالی فرجه شریف تبریک عرض میکنیم و به تمام مسلمین جهان و به شما مؤمنین محترم که حاضر هستین در این حسینیه معظم صلواتی بلند اینا فرمایید.
اللهم صل علی محمد و آل محمد.
انشاءالله که همه ما و شما از شفاعت آقا رسول الله بهره‌مند شویم. صلوات دوم را اینا فرمایید.
اللهم صل علی محمد و آل محمد.
عید رسول دو سرا رسول دو سرا و آمد منجی عالم زهرا آمد سید افلاک سلام علیک سید افلاک سلام علیک خواجه لولاک سلام علیک صلوات سلام بر تو قدر و جلال و عنوانت سلام چار کتاب خدا و قرآنت سلام بر تو یاسین نور و فرقانت سلام بر تو که سلمان بود مسلمانت سلام بر شرف و اقتدار سلمانت سلام مکه و غار حرام و پیمانت سلام بر تو مولا علی برادری تو صلوات سلام بر تو مولا علی برادری تو یگان فاتح بدر و حنین و خیبر تو صلوات هر دم صلوات بر جمالش هر دم صلوات بر جمالش بابا کیش روزی خرم آمد مبوس نبی اکرم آمد بس عید فرا رسید بی شک عیدی نبود چنین مبارک از بیست او جهان جوان شد گیتی چو بهشت جاودان شد یا رسول الله 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 جواب نام خدا نام خدا جواب جواب جوانا یا رسول الله 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 جواب بگو یا رسول الله 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 بس عید فرا رسید بی شک عید نبوت چنین مبارک از بعثت او جهان جوان شد گیتی چو بهشت جاودان شد این عید به اهل دین مبارک بر جمله مسلمین مبارک از غیب و ندا رسید او را آن ذات خجسته نیکو را که ای ذات نیکو پیمبر کن برخیز و به خلق رهبری کن یا رسول الله یا رسول الله یا رسول الله یا رسول الله نام خدا يا رسول الله 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 چون قدر مقام رهبری یافت در کوی حرا پیامبری یافت بشنید چو این ندا محمد بشنید چو این ندا محمد شد خاتم انبیا محمد صلوات هر روحی که دور از بدی شد با آمدنش محمدی شد قانون حیاتی استی آورد آیین خدا پرستی آورد پیدا چه شدن جمالی استی بشکست اساس بود پرستی یا رسول الله یا رسول الله یا رسول الله یا رسول الله نام خدا یا رسول الله یا رسول الله
ماشاءالله ماشاءالله جوانا
یا رسول الله یا رسول الله یا رسول الله یا رسول الله يا رسول الله يا رسول الله يا رسول الله يا رسول الله قانون حياتي استيار آوين خدا پرستيار پیدا چه شدن جمالی استی بشکست اساسی بود پرستی با بیستی آن نبی مرسل بود خانه بکن و شد مبدل هر دم صلوات بر جمالش بر احمد و بر علی و اولش صلوات هر دم صلوات بر جمالش بر احمد و بر علی و آلش یا رسول الله یا رسول الله یا رسول الله یا رسول الله نام خدا
ماشاءالله 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 مستوزه
يا رسول الله 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 صد شکر به دینی جنابم قرآن مقدسش کتابم خوشبخت کسی امتی اوست در سایه دین و رحمتی اوست از عرش و ملک دهد سلامش شد ختم پیامبری بنامش ای داده ای زما تا به ماوی برپا کی ذات تو گواوی در شان تو گفت کی زدی پاک
چی گفت؟
لولاک لما خلق الافلاک یا رسول الله یا رسول الله يا رسول الله يا رسول الله
نام خدا
يا
اگر انشالله میخواین که مدینه برویم و همچی روزی همچی شبی مدینه بشین جوابای خوب کوبنده بدیم. یا رسول الله یا رسول الله یا رسول الله یا رسول الله يا 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 رسول الله ای داد از زمای تو بماوی در پاکی ذات تو گواوی در شان تو گفت ایزدی پاک لولاک لماو خلق تو لفلاک ای بر سر هر پیمبری تاوچ قصه تو شام میراج قرآن کریم حجتی توست خوشبخت کسی که از امتی توست گر زیان که تو بود نمیشی کسی اسلام نبود وقت پرستی یا رسول الله یا رسول الله یا رسول الله نام خدا يا رسول الله 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 توحید به ما تو یاد دادی بتخانه و بود به باد دادی ای معنی ممکنات دریاب ای خواجه کائنات دریاب ما غیر تو داد رسی نداریم دریاب که هیچ کس نداریم یا رسول الله 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 رسول الله یا رسول الله یا رسول الله یا رسول الله عیان که تو یاری بینوایی فریاد رسوگر گشاوی دریاب که ما گناهکاریم ای امید شفاعت از تو داریم تنها نمنم مغم گرفتار غم از دل هر که هست بردار ای جان جهان فدای جانت شهری است غلام یا سلطان است یا رسول الله یا رسول الله ماشاءالله يا رسول الله يا
احسن طيب الله الفاسق من صغر سني عرفتها وصاحبتني وصاحبتها من صغر سني تحبني ومن صغر سني عشقتها وياها شفت الخير كله والسعد لما شفتها ما أظن يوم نسيتني ولا أظن يوم عفتها عاشت بقلبي حبيبة بكل فاية وكل مصيبة ولازمتني من الطفولة ولازمتها بأكلي وبشربي ومنامي حاضرة وما فارقتها. هي كم كلمة بعبارة من أبوي وأمي أنا تعلمتها، تطيب لساني وتعطره لو قلتها وأنطقتها. أريد أسألك يا الموالي من هاي الوصفتها، ما أظنك عنها غافل اليوم كم مرة قلتها الصلاة على النبي وآله. أحلى كلمات عرفتها. وعجل فرج أحسن. خب مجلس ما که ایزن بورینگ نشه، خسته نشید، یه برنامه هم داریم به زبان انگلیسی. خب کسایی که انگلیسیشون خوبه خوب گوش کنن، چون امکان داره آخر مجلس یه چند تا سوال بپرسیم و جایزه بدیم. جناب دوست عزیز سید مصطفی حسینی، مجلسمون را با چند کلمه به زبان انگلیسی به فیض میرسانند. سلامتی ایشون و تمامی مددهان اهل بیت صلواتی خط کنید.
دم به دم بر همه دم بر گل رخسار محمد و علی شیر خدا ساقی کوثر صلوات. Tonight I'm going to present to you a short speech about the biography of our beloved prophet Muhammad's life. Salawat. In the name of Allah, the merciful, the compassionate. In the name of the Lord who created man from a clod. Who taught by pen, taught man what he knew not. Salawat. The Prophet Muhammad was son of Abdullah, who was the son of Abdul Muttalib, who was the son of Hashim, whose ancestry reaches the Prophet Ismail, son of the Prophet Abraham, peace be upon them. Muhammad was born in the city of Mecca in Arabia on a Friday, the 17th day of the lunar month of Rabi, in the year 570 CE, into a noble family whose fathers and ancestors were amongst the chiefs of the Quraysh tribe and the Bani Hashim clan. His prophetic mission began in the year 610 CE on the 27th day of the month of Rajab, when he first received the divine revelation. Then the Quran was revealed to the prophet progressively according to the circumstances of the time over a period of 23 years. Muhammad's father, Abdullah, son of Abdul Muttalib, was the best and most pious amongst the sons of Abdul Muttalib and his most beloved. Abdullah died while Muhammad was in his mother's womb. All that he left behind were 5 camels and a servant girl named Baraka, who was Muhammad's nanny. Abdullah was a true believer and a monotheist. After Abdullah's death, Muhammad's grandfather, Abdul Muttalib, became his guardian. Abdul Muttalib was one of the chieftains of the tribe of Quraysh and a believer in Allah in the way of Prophet Abraham. And as was Abu Talib, a brother of Abdullah. Abdul Muttalib always respected and honored treaties and adopted the finest of morals. Muhammad's mother was Amina, daughter of Wahhab. She was also a believer in Allah. When Muhammad was born, his mother said, "As soon as I put my child on the ground, He leaned with his hands on the ground, raised his head to the skies, and looked at the horizons, all the while speaking in phrases of monotheism. Then a voice called out to me, saying, "The best of mankind has been born, so name him Muhammad." Then Amina sent for Abdul Muttalib. He came to her and she said, "A wondrous boy has been born to you." Then she brought baby Muhammad to him. Abdul Muttalib looked at him, then took him and entered the Kaaba and prayed to Allah. Then he left the Kaaba and returned him to his mother and named him Muhammad. Muhammad was not yet 7 years old when his mother died. After his mother's death, his grandfather Abdul Muttalib assumed guardianship of him. Because of his knowledge of the status of the child and his faith in him, he treated Muhammad with more care and attention than his other children. Muhammad grew up to become a fine young man. He became known for his excellent manners, and because of the honesty in his conduct and dealing, he was referred to as As-Sadiq, the truthful one. And Al-Amin, the trustworthy one. As a youngster, Muhammad used to accompany his uncle on his business trip to Syria. When the Messenger of Allah reached the age of 12, he journeyed with his uncle Abu Talib as far as Basra. There he was seen by a Christian monk named Georges, who recognized him by his description. He took his hand and said, "This is the chief of the world. God will send him as a mercy to the world." Abu Talib said, "How do you know this?" He said, "We find mentions of him in our books." He asked Abu Talib to take him back, fearing his safety. As an adult, Muhammad worked as a trader between the cities of Mecca and Damascus, and earned a great reputation in the process. Having heard of the reputation of Muhammad, Lady Khadija, one of the noblest of Quraysh, on one occasion commissioned him to take charge of some of a trading business between the two cities. Having seen his performance in the business and the return he had produced, as well as his honesty, Lady Khadija put Muhammad in charge of her business. Although she had many proposals of marriage from various dignitaries of the Quraysh, Lady Khadija declined them all. It is reported that it was Lady Khadija who, albeit indirectly and discreetly, made the marriage proposal to Muhammad. Some historians have reported that when they married in 595 CE, they were both 27. Lady Khadija gave birth to 3 children. All of the Prophet's children were from Khadija. The boys all died young during the lifetime of the Prophet. His only daughter was Fatima, who was married to Imam Ali, son of Abu Talib, and bore him Imam Hassan and Imam Hussein, Zainab and Umm Kulthum, and another son who was named Mohsen by the Prophet before his birth. The Prophet Muhammad used to spend much time in prayer and worship of the one God. This he used to do in a cave known as Hira, in the An-Nur mountains near the city of Mecca. In 610 CE, at the age of 40, Muhammad received the first of the divine revelation when he was engaged in devotion and prayed inside the cave of Hira. "In the name of Allah, the Merciful, the Compassionate. Read in the name of the Lord who created men from a cloth. Read, the Lord is the most noble, who taught by pen, taught men what he knew not." The Prophet Muhammad conveyed the news and the message to Ali and Lady Khadija. Ali and Lady Khadija both embraced and the new revelation instantly and without any hesitation. Khadija was thus the first woman to believe in the Messenger of Allah and the first woman to pray with him. The Prophet Muhammad faced a lot of hardship but did not lose his faith to Allah and did what Allah ordered him to without any hesitation. The Prophet Muhammad was killed by poisoning on the 28th day of the month of Safar in the 11th year of Hijrah, 630 CE. Reflecting upon the Prophet's life, we understand that even though the Prophet went through a lot of hardship and poverty, but he still believed and was humble towards Allah. This is a good example for the believers today, that no matter how much hardship and misery a person goes through, he or she should be thankful to Allah. Salla ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad.
أحسنت. صلوات 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 على محمد صلوات صلوات على محمد صلواتون 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 صلوات صلوات على محمد صلوات قال يا إلهي ومجيري من بعلم الغيب يعلم صل يا ربي وسلم ثم بارك وترحم وترفق برسول طاهر بالخير مفعم ذلك المبعوث طه وعلى الخلق المقدم في السماء في السماء هو المؤيد صلوات صلوات على محمد صلوات 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 على محمد صلوات صلوات على محمد صلوا على محمد وآل محمد.